Americas have become a consideration to every propaganda office and to every general staff beyond the seas. The vast amount of our resources, the vigor of our commerce, and the strength of our men have made us vital factors in world peace, whether we choose it or not. For years, when Canadians and Americans have met, they have lightheartedly saluted as North American friends with little thought of dangers from overseas. I give to you assurance that the people of the United States will not stand idly by if domination of Canadian soil is threatened by any other empire.
History which may well be the pride of the peoples of this continent. It also has its great natural beauty. Where in the whole wide world is there a more majestic approach to the interior of any land, more in the way of a never-changing loveliness on an unprecedented scale? Upon a bridge itself a symbol of international friendship and goodwill, we are celebrating once again a century and more of peace between the United States and Canada. When we reflect upon the disputed frontiers which threaten peace in other quarters of the globe, we cannot but feel that the ceremony in which we are participating has in it something of significance to the world.